let not the pit shut its mouth on me. Hear me, O Lord, for your loving kindness is good. Turn to me according to the multitude of your tender mercies, and do not hide your face from your servant, for I am in trouble. Hear me speedily. Draw near to my soul and redeem it.
Streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels have trod. Jerusalem, I want to rest on the banks of your river, in that city.
Thank you. Jerusalem,
here in the vicinity. We're not sure exactly where because of earthquakes and everything else that have happened since this time, but we know it happened. We know Jesus died and was buried and rose again. I'm going to read a couple of scriptures here. First one I want to read, really, before we go into communion, is about the crucifixion and resurrection of Jesus Christ. It says in John chapter 19 and verse 17, "And he, Jesus, bearing his cross, went out to a place called the place of a skull." Notice that. It didn't say he was on the place, but he went out where that place was. People knew where that was, which is called in the Hebrew tongue, Golgotha, where they crucified him and two others with him, one on either side, and Jesus in the center. We were at Gethsemane yesterday where he had prayed, "My Father, if there's been any way, let this cup pass from me. But nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done." Because Jesus willingly went to the cross. Under the obedience of the Father, he went there to die for our sin.
And life is worth a living just because he lives.
Amen. Thank you, buddy. In Luke chapter 22, it says, "When the hour had come, Jesus sat down with the 12 apostles with him. Then he said to them, 'With fervent desire, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I say to you, I will no longer eat. Excuse me. I will no longer eat of it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God.' Then he took the cup and gave thanks and said, 'This Take this cup and divide it among yourselves. For I say to you, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes.' And he took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to them, saying, 'This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me.' And likewise, he also took the cup after the supper, saying, 'This cup is now the new covenant of in my blood, which is shed for you.'" All right, let's take the wafer, please. Verse 20 says, "Likewise, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you.'" The juice. The cups are a souvenir.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because I know he
has been born.
We're standing on top of the Temple Mount, aka Mount Moriah, the same mountain on which Abraham was commanded to come and tie up his son, his only son, which you love, Isaac, and sacrifice him to the Lord, an ultimate test of faith. So that was Mount Moriah. The place where Christ stood, entered the triumphal entry, and God willing, don't cheer now, but God willing, soon enough, the cedar locks and cement will disappear, and the Lord will enter through these gates, which were sealed by the Muslims.